Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh. Today I'm going to talk to you about Holla Mohalla. Holla Mohalla is the Sikh festival which is all about being a saint soldier. The words Holla Mohalla stand for attack and counter-attack. You may remember that when Guru Gobind Singh Ji came to this world, he came with a mission, and part of that mission was to uphold saints everywhere, to protect saints everywhere, and to protect everyone and everything, they created the Khalsa. So the Khalsa needed to be trained in battle strategy and warfare. So Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj invited everyone from all over India, from wherever the Sikh Sangat was based, to come to Anandpur Sahib, and in particular at the site of Sri Holgarh Sahib. On this day, Guru Gobind Singh Ji would instruct the Khalsa to split up into two armies, one who would protect a certain area of land and the other who would attack that land. And what would happen? The soldiers or the Khalsa armies or the participants of the Khalsa who were so good and so cunning and were really, really good at attacking or defending, they would receive sropals, they would receive rewards from the hands of Guru Gobind Singh Ji in the evening. To cater for the large amount of Khalsa who had accumulated at Sri Anandpur Sahib, large distributions of langar took place. So there were langars or large meals being distributed all over Sri Anandpur Sahib.
The birthplace of Khalsa, the town of Anandpur Sahib, hosts the mega Sikh festival of Holla Mohalla. It is one of the largest gatherings of Sikhs in the world. Over 5 million congregate here during the festival. And witness the martial valor and skills of the fearless Nihangs. Nearly 200 community kitchens or langars will crop up all over the town. At the heart of it all will be the largest langar, at Gurudwara Sri Keshgarh Sahib. Watch the holy town of Anandpur Sahib transform into a mega kitchen.
A very famous Sikh writer wrote about Holla Mohalla being celebrated, and he says, Acharaj Bidatyo Panth Jag Kishu Na Mani Kaan Deg Deg Ke Bali Bad Banke Beer Sujan. This basically translates as the wondrous Khalsa Panth who came to be known as fearless across the world, exceptional in the distribution not only of the meal but the sword as well. The brave, great, knowledgeable, handsome and beautiful warriors. The words Mohalla Kadna refers to a parade that takes place of the whole Khalsa army moving from one Gurdwara in procession to another. In the front of this procession, usually there are five Singhs with Nishan Sahibs, and there are Nagaras playing. There are also Farare that can be, which are anointed and held by the Sikh warriors. There is a huge display of martial prowess in the whole festival. There is a saying attributed to Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj, Auran ki holi mam hola, karo kripa nit bachan amola. The gracious Guru, who was full of blessings, said these amazing words. He said, other people celebrate holi, but for us the Khalsa, we celebrate Holla. What's the link to holi? The story behind holi is linked two different Sakhis. One Sakhi of Bhagat Prahlad Ji and the other of Sri Krishna Bhagwan Ji. The Sakhi of Bhagat Prahlad Ji, he was a child saint, and his father Hrnakash had a brother called Hiranyakashyap. Hiranyakashyap and Hrnakash were two brothers who had unsaintly qualities. Hrnakash went into the jungles to do penance after his brother Hiranyakashyap was killed. At that time, the leader of godly qualities or saintly qualities, his name was Indar, they went to strike down the kingdom of Hrnakash in the place which is now in Pakistan called Multan. He took Harnakish's wife, her name was Kyadu, as a prisoner. He met a saint called Narada Ji on his way who convinced Indar to leave Gyadu with him. Naradji then proceeded to take Gyadu to his own ashram. She was expecting a child at this time. This child was to be Bhakt Prahladji, and she gave birth to Prahladji in the ashram itself. In the ashram, it is said that Naradji narrated the whole katha, or the whole narration. He explained the whole narration of the whole creation itself and how God created everything to Gyadu. And obviously, having these vibrations, these positive vibrations from the words of a saint, the child who heard all the katha in the stomach was going to be born as a saint. Harnaksh, on the other hand, was busy worshipping Brahmaji, who, pleased with his determination, appeared and gave him the chance to ask a boon. So Harnaksh proceeded to ask for a boon which he thought was quite absolute. And he asked for that he shouldn't die in the day or night, he wouldn't die by cause of a weapon used in the hand or a weapon thrown. No human or animal could kill him. He wouldn't die on the earth or in the sky. And he thought that this was a complete bhajan, or a complete boon to immortality. Blessed with these boons, he returned to Multan and he saw that his whole kingdom had been uprooted by the Devate. So he attacked the celestial beings and took over their realms, he took over their kingdoms. And Harnaksh had started thinking by this time that he was God himself, and began to tell all others that his own name should be worshipped everywhere. So he took his wife and son from Narad's ashram back home with him. Obviously at this time, Harnaksh's ego began to grow. When Bhakt Prahladji got the age of 5, his father thought it was a good time for him to go and attend school. Instead of learning in the school, he made all the other children recite the name of God, which was Ram at that time, i.e. the name of God immersed everywhere. The infuriated Harnaksh and his wife tried to convince their son not to repeat the name of God. But in his defiance, Prahlad continued to recite the name of God, or recite the name of Ram, going against his parents' wishes. So Harnaksh got various ideas to kill his own son. He tried to poison him, he threw him into a pit of snakes, but he wasn't successful. When the poison didn't work, the snakes encircled and began to respect Prahladji. In relation to Holi itself, Harnaksh had a sister called Holika, who possessed a special blanket which could prevent flames from reaching her. He asked her to invite Prahlad to sit in her laps, and while she would wear the blanket herself, then he would sit. She would immolate herself and she would survive, and therefore Prahlad would die. But actually the opposite happened. Holika went up in flames, and as a result, today people celebrate Holika Dahan, which means Holika died. So this is celebrated before Holi itself. It represents evil being defeated by goodness and the saints being protected by God. In this festival also, color is synonymous with the celebration of Holi. This is linked to the time when Sri Krishna Bhagwanji was poisoned by a demon called Putana. She poisoned him with her breast milk. Putana was destroyed and Krishna's skin turned a blue color. So Krishna was worried if the fair-skinned Radha and her companions, his friends, would ever accept him because of the way he looked. Then Krishna's mother asked him to approach Radha and her friends and smear their faces with any color he wanted. So this playful coloring gradually evolved as a tradition. So what is the place of Holi and color throwing in Sikhi? Guru Arjan Dev Ji, the fifth guru, was once asked the same question. How do we celebrate Holi, they asked. And at that time, Sri Harmandir Sahib, the golden temple, was being built by Guru Arjan Dev Sahib Ji Maharaj. Guru Arjan Dev Ji instructed all the Sikhs how to get the best out of Holi. And they recited a Shabd in Basant Rag. Basant means you bloom, a rag sung in the springtime. And Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj said, Holi ki ni sant sev, rang laga at the Lal Dev, which means that if you're going to celebrate Holi, the greatest form of celebration is to serve the saints. And then Rang Laga at the Lal Dev, if we are to throw color, then the greatest color you will receive, you'll be dyed in it, rang laga at lal dev, you'll be colored in the name of God and in the knowledge of God. So the link was created to obtaining the blessings of God by doing seva of his anointed saints and being dyed in the color of the teachings of those saints or the spiritual knowledge of God. Bhai Nandalal Singh Ji, the esteemed poet of Guru Gobind Singh Ji's court, explains how Guru Gobind Singh Ji took part in the first holla, and he said that Guru Gobind Singh Ji himself carried a pishkari, which is a cartridge full of color, and he said that gulal of shaniye daste mubarak zameeno aasmara surkh ru kard. In Persian he says that Guru Gobind Singh Ji had this color in his hands, and they said that Guruji has thrown worldly and spiritual color on me, and Guruji holds the color in his hands. Blessed are his hands, and blessed is the color he holds. So basically, Guru Gobind Singh Ji was described as holding every single power in his hands, and he blessed that power on all his Sikhs, whether it was fearlessness in the battlefield or whether it was God's intelligence or God-telligence. So what can we take away from this talk? Firstly, celebrate Holi by visiting your Guru and get dyed in the spiritual knowledge of God. Secondly, celebrate Hola Mohalla by keeping fit and strong. Thirdly, think of the fearless and loving presence of Guru Gobind Singh Ji on the day. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.